Do you think it's different to color grade your images because you don't really know how to achieve certain looks? Almost all you need to know about are color wheels. Color wheels are used to color grade your photos and video footage. It's commonly used in the film industry for ages, and it found its way into color grading your photographic works as well. So, what exactly are color wheels and how can we use them as photographers? Let me explain. Color wheels are, as the name suggests, circles which include a spectrum of different colors available to edit with. The center of a wheel is white and the saturation of each color increases towards the edges of a circle. This makes it easy for us to select hue and saturation for our color grading. Also, we have three of these wheels, one for the highlights, one for the midtones, and one for the shadow parts of an image. When we look at this black to white gradient, we already see where the shadows, highlights, and midtones are. Now let me show you how you can color these specific parts by using the color wheels. If you use the shadow wheel and select this blue color, we can see how it affects only the shadow region of the image. Same thing for the highlights. If you're going to use this red color for the highlights, we can see how the bright parts of this gradient turn red as well. To color the middle part, we can use the midtones wheel and select the bright green. Now we have a colorful gradient instead of black and white. If you want to select another color but leave the saturation as it is, you can simply move that little point around the circle. And for the other way around, if you're happy with your selected color but want to decrease the saturation, you can move that inner point back towards the white center. We also have some sliders under each wheel. This is where you can brighten or darken the specific parts of your image. So if you want to brighten up your shadows, you just have to crank this little slider to the right, and if you want to darken your highlights, move this slider to the left. In this window we have all the three circles at once, but we can also change it to only see the shadow wheel, all the highlights wheel, and so on. And if you do this, we have one more option to select your color by clicking on this field. There you can color pick a color from your image or select a color from a palette which you can create by right clicking on this color and selecting set the swatch current color. There are two more sliders at the bottom of this tool. The blending slider controls the amount of overlap between highlights and shadows. So if you move this all the way up to 100, we can see that the midtones almost disappear. They are still there, but the shadows and highlights move a little bit closer to the center to blend all these parts together. If we now move it to the left, we can see that the midtones get a little bit more space and therefore the green gets a little bit more vibrant. The balance slider will control the variation of color between the highlights, midtones, and shadows. So if we move this to the left, it reduces the amount of highlights in the image and the shadows get more space. Now let's see how we can use this tool on an image. This photo was taken on a summer evening and I already did some basic color corrections, brightened up the shadows and decreased the highlights to make everything more visible. To make it not look so flat, I already increased the contrast a little bit. And now this is where the fun part starts. I want to make it look like the sun would color the sky a little bit more to achieve some sort of sunset look. So what I like to do is put some dark blue tones into the shadows like this. To make the sky appear more orange, we can now move that highlight slider up to a reddish color and increase the saturation a lot to make it stand out even more. We can do the same with the midtones, but with much less saturation. This way it looks even more like a summer evening atmosphere. I would also suggest making the shadows a bit darker, but also the highlights. We can also move the balance a little bit to the left so that the blue tones get a little bit more action. Here's another photo we can have some fun with. This portrait screams for a rather cinematic look, and with a color grading tool it's rather easy to achieve that. Like the other one, I already did some basic color corrections so we can only concentrate on the grading part. For this I will also make the shadows appear a bit more blue. This makes the image a little bit more contrasty in general. To make this look more cinematic and make the fog in the background appear more vibrant, I'm going to select the bright blue color for the highlights and increase the saturation a tiny bit as well. This looks really cool already. To make the skin tones on this portrait appear more natural, we can now select an orange color for the midtones and just move it a tiny bit to the edge of a circle. just brings back the natural colors on her face rather than having it blue. To make this even better, we can decrease the blending to show off more of the midtones and also move the balance slider slightly to the right to increase the highlight color in this whole image. Looking at our before and after, this looks so much better, and we achieved a cinematic look by only touching these three color wheels. I hope you could learn a little bit more about color grading in general and how to use the color grading tool in Lightroom. I think there's a lot of power in it and you can definitely work some magic with it. It also helps a lot to try out different things and see how coloring shadows or highlights affects different images. This way you can definitely find a style and a certain workflow for editing your photos. I will see you in the next video.